about, she's been wrote about, she's been talked about constantly. She's been up and down, she's been pushed around, but they held her down. NYC. She has no regrets, she accepts the past. All these things they help to make she.
Be like, hey everybody, how's everybody doing? Do you wanna have a drink? Do you wanna smoke? Do you wanna talk? Do you wanna hang out? Do you wanna try to go to the club? Like, and everyone's just like, and I'm like, okay, it is completely up to you. I'll see you next time. You go on about your bad self, you know? But other than that, it's like really, like, it's like, you know, adults have tried to teach me how to just be myself. Adults, before I was an adult, they tried to teach me how to be an adult by saying, don't ever let nobody get you upset to the point where X, Y, and Z. Don't ever let anybody get into your life and try to fuck your life up, X, Y, and Z. Don't ever try to, you know what I'm saying? And then it's like everything, you know what? It's the unlearning. All right, I understand the unlearning of the learning or the learning of the unlearning. I understand that. But at the end of the day, if that's all that I've had put and fed into my mind from as a child, then how else am I supposed to, how else am I supposed to navigate the world without the knowledge that I already have? How? How am I supposed to navigate the world without the knowledge that I already have? And how am I, and if it made sense to me, then how the fuck would I want to change it if it made sense to me? You know? Why would I want to change knowledge? Knowledge is knowledge and knowledge is infinite. Why would I want to change it? Maybe I shouldn't sit in the hallway no more because I think people have an issue with me sitting in the hallway. So maybe like the laundromat and outside, and if I can, maybe in the car at some point in time. But I think people are starting to feel uncomfortable with me sitting in the hallway, which is fine. You know, that means that they're watching me. You know, that means that they're not concerned. They're in my business way too fucking much. That's what that means. What else could it be? That means that their eyeballs are glued to me. You know, they think that I'm gonna harm them in any way or something like that. But really, what it is is there's a plug there where I can be able to do what I do with Wi-Fi, so I use the outlet there, you know. That's what, you know, so I have more Wi-Fi when I'm in the building. If I go anywhere else, there's no Wi-Fi. So, you know, like that, you know. So, but anyway, maybe they think I'm a disturbance, but really I'm not a disturbance. I was loud once, and he told me to, the guy said, oh, could you please, lower your voice? And I said, okay, no problem. I don't have a problem with lowering my voice. Sure. I don't have a problem with that. I'll go somewhere else. You know, I didn't know you were that close to the door. You know, how the fuck am I supposed to know? But anyway, it's not about these people. That's, you know, so at the end of the day, like, I just want, you know, I just want the best for myself. And I don't think there's anything wrong with that. And then that goes for men, that goes for the men I allow in my life. And that goes for anybody that I allow in my life, you know. That goes for that. That's what it goes for. Not just, you know, I don't want to just be.
She's been lost and found and she's still around. There's a reason for everything. Yeah, you know, I've been holding.